remember before I had children, I used to send money to my family in Nigeria, just sending them money. And then life happened. I had my own family and I could not send the money as before. What did they start saying? Tina has never sent us any money. All she cares about is her husband and her children. Even when my friend said, but she used to send to you before. That's past story, they said. That's past story. That's people soon forget. In the wilderness, whenever the people wanted water, they will forget what God had done. If they want meat, they will forget what God had done. People's memories are short. If all you have to leave behind is money, once that money is finished, they will forget about you. And they will say you have never done anything for them before. So it's best to leave a legacy. Leave something everlasting behind so they will remember you by that.
If you're a man, I want you to pay attention to this video. I'm going to be telling you the kind of woman that you should avoid as a man. So open your ears and listen to me. Number one, you see that woman that does not like your family, run, because she will kill you. Never you marry a woman that does not like your family, because your family is you. Your family is your roots. Your family is your blood. When a woman is ready to accept you, she should be ready to accept your family. That is what comes with it. So you see that woman and say, I don't like your mother. I don't like your sister. I don't like your run from her. If she can endure you and tolerate you, she should be able to do the same with your family. Number two, the spenders. You see that woman that cannot keep money. If you give her money, story. Every time money enters her hand, it is one story or the other. Money used to bite her. She has an itching hand. She is a spender, not Mrs. Chop Chop. Don't marry that kind of woman. It simply means that when you marry a chop chop woman, a woman that is a spender, it simply means that she is not futuristic. She cannot prepare for tomorrow. She's going to eat both your destiny and your children's destiny, because she does not see above her eyes. She only sees what her eye can see. So she's going to chop everything around her. You need to pay attention to this. And never marry a woman that cannot keep money. Even change, she cannot keep. If she cannot keep money, how do you expect her to save for the rainy days? May. Pay attention. Number three. The gossipers. You see those women that like gossip. Those kind of women that cannot have productive discussions with you. Every time you are sitting with your woman, is them say, Mama Nkechi say, you know that Mama Onitsha said, you know, they are always doing them say. It's a difference between discussing with your partner and a woman that is always gossiping. She doesn't have any other thing to tell you apart from them say, Mama Neka say, Mama Nkechi say, Mama Tai will say. Every time is gossip, that kind of woman is going to put you into problem, because she doesn't have anything productive in her head. That kind of woman have what is called complex issues. She have to pull people down to feel good about herself. Run from the gossipers. Women who cannot communicate, women who do not have any productive discussion to add. They can't add to your business, they can't add to your work, they can't add to the future. They don't even bring anything to the table that is going to yield. Every time is them say. Run. Number four, the naggers. You see those women that cannot have a conversation with you without raising their voice, without shouting, without turning every discussion, conversation, and argument into a fight. Run from them, because they are going to nag your destiny away from you. The highest thing that takes a lot of men to their early grave is nag, because a woman is going to nag, 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 and nag your destiny away. So once you see that for every slight discussion, communication, argument, or small fight, you don't begin to shout, you are more, you are more than you are. She don't begin to point her, they owe you for shirts, they shake things, they, hey, my brother, run, run for your dear life. Because a lot of women cannot have a conversation or a discussion without arguing or without fighting. It simply means they cannot take correction. And the last but not the least, the pretenders. In the scent. In the forbid. God forbid. Oh. God forbid. You are holier than thou. Pretenders. Run from them. Such women are the most deadly women. If you begin to dig into their past, in fact, their past is rotten. Run from women who are pretentious. Run from women who always act as if their sense. Do not always act as if their sense. Hey! My brother, run. No. Run. With this few points of mine, I hope I've been able to convince or not to confuse you that you should not marry this kind of women. Men, these days, you need to shine your eyes. Sapanyagi! Use hypo. Sanitize your eyes before you say you're going to choose a woman to keep in your house, because some women will take you to your early grave. So you need to pay attention and marry a woman who is debt, not shallow. A woman who is futuristic, not now woman. Shine your eyes, too.